5 years ago was the 70th anniversary of the invasion of Eden, Normandy, right? Eden. So the Cancer Society was trying to partner with the VA. And we send out letters to every organization we can think of. Who shows up? Anthony and one of his friends. That's it. So now, fast forward to last year, and the Cancer Society actually did partner with the VA, and we had about 30 or 40 veterans last year. So, but Anthony came back to us 4 years later as a cancer survivor. So please, give him a round of applause. Believe me, his friends, these gentlemen are all veterans. So please, thank them for their service and for their community survival. So that's very important. So, we're good. So, I have a very hard time telling people that I am a cancer survivor. It will be 5 years next week that I was told those three words, you have cancer. But in my case, I was extremely lucky. I knew something was wrong. I went and saw my doctor. She looked at me, she's like, go to this doctor. I can't even help you. So I go see another doctor. She says, we're going to do this procedure on you. You're going to be fine. So they go, they do the procedure on a Friday. She calls me Monday, and she says, yes, it's as I suspected. You have endometrial cancer, but it's early. You're going to be fine. Fast forward 10 days, I'm in the oncologist's office. He says, this is what we're going to do. A week after that, I had a full hysterectomy done laparoscopically. 10 days later, I was back at work. And I consider myself the luckiest cancer survivor on the face of this earth because they caught it early. And I tell people the worst part of my cancer journey was I couldn't play golf for 6 weeks. That was it. No chemo, no radiation, nothing. That's why I always have a hard time telling people that I am a survivor, because I didn't do the chemo, I didn't do the radiation, I never got sick. So for me, it's just really hard to do that. But this lady lives in Tara, and my friend Mandy Onward, who actually works for the American Cancer Society on the Cancer Action Network side, has said to me, you're the survivor we want, because we caught you early. And because of early detection, I'm here, and because I had such great doctors and such great care, that's why I'm here. And it's the research dollars that the Cancer Society and the Cancer Action Network helps to raise that we can do what we do. Now I'm going to tell you about Teresa and I met. Teresa and I met through an organization.